Yes, on paper right now, we might look favorites because of what we did to DR Congo, but I'd like to believe that that respect has got to come from your end on the other side, but the football will do the talking.
Yeah, but at the end of the day, you can't deny fans
from saying what they feel like.
Exactly. That's what excites them. That's what they need at the end of the day, because they are looking for happiness. That's what gives them happiness.
Brian, how damaging is this for Zimbabwe? Yes, you've lost the first game against Egypt, and now you're going into a game whereby there is so much belief from the team that you'll be facing, that is in Uganda. And on paper, you're the underdog. And then on top of that, you turn into social media, and there's so much hate coming in from the entire world. How do you deal with this damage going into the game, especially when you're seeking for your first win?
I think, first of all, the Zimbabwe players are professionals. They understand that as fans, there's always going to be all this banter, because banter is also part of the game, and fans are always going to come out and speak their minds. But it's about focusing on what happens on the field of play down to those 90 minutes, and ultimately, the tweets and the conversation on social media clearly stays as banter, and that is pretty much what it tends to be. So for Zimbabwe, there's no overstating how much they'll need a positive result in that particular game, because just like for most of these other teams, they understand that there is their performance will be riding on that, and certainly if they're going to finish anywhere to progress into the next round, they'll need to pick up a decent result in that particular game. So it's going to be extremely important, but it will also be equally important for the Cranes.
As we progress in this tournament, if we do progress in that particular regard, there's always going to be a much bigger task or a much bigger challenge whereby you'll be facing much bigger sides, the likes of Ivory Coast, Senegal. They usually suspects. It gets even worse, because then you have to have a much bigger approach, if I should, in that regard. But for the Ugandan Cranes right now, it's focusing what you have at the moment and then worry about the things that will be coming in later on. But for Sebastian De Sebra, at this point in time, he must know that he has the team together. He must know that he knows the kind of squad he'll be fielding tomorrow. He must know that the entire country now has a sense of belief that now we're here, we need to arrive and make a statement.
Yeah, our target, first of all, our target was qualification from the group stages. Now, after qualifying, it's going to give the team some sort of relief from that pressure of not qualifying from the group stages. And now I think they'll begin playing without so much pressure, but at the same time, we'll have introduced ourselves, because knockout stage in a tournament like
one bad game and you send back home.
Exactly. So teams will now be playing at the same level with other teams, because they'll be respecting us.
An
so
element
the thing
of
we are going to win out of that is much respect from the other groups.
Bran, an element of luck before we can close this subject tends to win you championship. We saw Chelsea, their first Champions League title, beating Bayern late on. We saw Zambia when they won that shootout against Ivory Coast. Time and again, you have that bit of luck that might be on your side. And I feel like this might be our time. Not playing football based on luck, but again, a little bit of luck to actually push this team to the farthest in this competition.
You can't separate luck from football.
Well, sometimes you need it, sometimes you need it. But quickly, for the Ugandan Cranes tomorrow, might luck be on our side and have us qualify and reach the knockout stage?
I think luck certainly plays a significant role, especially in sports and specifically in tournaments, because what happens is you've got about, what, 7 games to play all across, so it's pretty much going to come down to which opponents you're going to face along the way. Certainly, a couple of decisions that go your way, because it's down to the final margins. You know, if things are playing out in your way, you could actually go all the way and perhaps get to clinch the silverware, so it always comes into play.
Coach, finally, we have had a number of empty seats, not just for the game, for the Uganda games, but we had them throughout the Kenya game, the Mali game against Mauritania, pretty much empty seats. Can we have more numbers as the tournament progresses?
I think it's going to remain the same, because one, Africans, we are poor. We can't, because it would be Ugandans, now like we're playing Zimbabwe, Ugandans, Zimbabwe would be the ones feeding the stadiums, not Egyptians,
the host nation.
Because for them it doesn't matter if they always a few stadiums when their team is playing. So it would be us, but how many of Ugandans can make it
can afford the trip?
Yeah. Secondly, even those who could afford, some of them were denied access to visas, so the bureaucracy was a little bit high, and so many people could not beat it. So it has to go back to the organizers of this tournament. One, to make it easier for people mm-hmm. who are intending to go and mm-hmm. watch the games to do it. Then secondly, of course, we are poor as a nation. We are
I hate poor, that so word poor, but anyway, that's the truth. Quickly before I let you go, coach, your prediction, Uganda versus Zimbabwe.
I think we'll get a point out of it.
A point. Yeah. A point. Brian, 3 points, a point?
I'll choose to be optimistic. I'll mm-hmm. go with my mind and I'll go to one for the Cranes.
I'll choose to be shush because then I'll shush until the game tomorrow. Thank you so much, coach, for coming through, making time for us. Obviously, for the Uganda Cranes, they will be in contention tomorrow against Zimbabwe. Then on Sunday, they get to finish their group stage campaign against the Pharaohs. That is in Egypt of coach Javier Aguirre. From myself and the entire team here at Urban TV and Game On production team, we get to see you tomorrow to discuss the game itself, game day, Uganda Cranes against Zimbabwe. For now, have yourselves a blessed Tuesday afternoon. Keep it right here on Urban TV.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports. Game On is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
All new and fresh and urban.